Hello everybody, it's Current Cartoon TV coming with another Steven Universe review. This one is on the actual special Stranded. And we have our special guest, Red.
Hey guys.
And we also have Gundam over there.
Hey guys.
Hey Gundam, guess what?
Lars.
Yes, you got your Lars fix out of this one.
Oh boy, it's so good. You'll see.
Yeah, oh yeah, so Gundam, give me that synapse for that Lars episode you so wanted so badly.
The synopsis of the episode is that Steven and Connie travel through Lion's Mane to visit Lars. Lars! When they reach the other side, they discover that Lars and the other off-color gems have stolen a spaceship from Emerald and are now on the run from their pursuers.
Oh yeah, they are definitely on the run. Alright, Gundam, give me what you liked about this episode.
What I liked about the episode is the colors were vibrant, amazing, absolutely brilliant. The atmosphere of the space battle, you know, being able to show that he's the captain. Lars was immediately 1,000% better than any previous version of Lars I've ever seen. Plot was everywhere. Loved it. It actually moved the story forward, and it was absolutely brilliant.
And how about you, Red? What did you like about this episode?
What I liked about this is plot! Oh my god, finally! Thank you! That sweet, sweet plot. Loved it. Love how finally Lars came back. Love everything about this episode. I really love how mature and grown up Lars has become over this time. We still don't know if there's any time differences between how long Lars has been in space between how long Steven and Connie have been on Earth, so there could be, like, a day could mean weeks in Homeworld, so who knows about that, but still, I love how he looked, I love the character designs, the colors, everything just looks so crisp. And we finally get to see Stevonnie again, so it's another good change of pace, so I enjoyed that.
And talking about that time span, I do think there was a little time before or after when Steven and Connie got back together and all that, because Connie's hair now is a little longer than what it was at Kevin's party. She had actually a ponytail in the back.
Yeah, well, you can still do, even if you have short hair, you can still make it a little ponytail, so who knows how long time has passed.
Yeah, so what I liked about this episode was that the reaction of Steven when he came actually seeing Lars when he first popped out of the head, it was like, Lars, what's going on? I thought you were going to be in a little cave crying yourself to sleep still, but no, Lars has grown a lot, except that one little scene, and I'm just nitpicking here, where he thought Sadie was forcing to hurt him by hanging out with the cool kids and moving on with life without him, but like Steven says, life moves on, so. But that is one thing I do like about it. I also like how Lars looks like Captain Hammock from that anime. I totally forgot the anime name at the top, but he has that scar, he has that cape, he has that freaking... Ugh, it's so freaking awesome.
He's got that charisma that I really enjoy. Like,
I agree. He has that status now. Yeah. Like that he's a BA. No cursing, but he's a BA.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he's not that shy, kind of obnoxious kid anymore. He's this charismatic guy.
Yeah, he used to want to be with the cool kids. Now he is the cool kid.
Exactly. He is the cool kid.
So, all right. I'm going to go into the dislikes. Anybody on the table have a dislike?
Nope.
None.
Nothing from me here either.
Unless
so
we're grasping at straws, I got nothing.
Yeah, I there's like little nitpicking here, and I know there's some errors in the animation department, but we don't look for those.
Yeah. All that plot, sweet plot.
Ooh, just like that's peanut sweet butter. Just put that right on toast.
Spread it on.
So, let's go into ratings here. So, Gundam, I'm gonna go with you first. What do you give it?
5 out of 5. If I could go higher, I would.
Red?
Absolutely. 5 out of 5. This was a phenomenal episode.
I'm going to follow suit here. It is a perfect episode. 5 out of 5 for myself, too. So then we're going to go into the next episode because you can't have one without the other. So we're going to go to Jungle Moon. So Red, give me the synapse for that episode.
Sure. So Stevonnie crash lands in a jungle on an alien moon and unable to contact Lars must fend for themselves. Little side note, I love how they say themselves. It's not himself or herself. I like that.
Oh, yeah.
And they discover that the moon houses an abandoned gem base and orbits a former gem colony. And Stevonnie has a strange dream involving the diamonds.
Yes, they does have a strange dream involving the diamonds. And we'll get into that a little later. Red, what do you like about this episode?
Again, more plot. Thank you. I love the different planet. We finally get to see something new other than Earth for about 6 episodes. So it's a nice change of pace. I like how they added Stevonnie's stubble.
Oh, that was
so cool. Just the littlest thing, it really makes a big difference.
The smallest details do make the biggest difference, really, honestly.
Absolutely. I like the Jurassic Park throwback when Stevonnie hides behind the door of the colony and that thing just screams and then kind of breathes and sniffs her and you get that little poof of air. It's like, oh yeah, Jurassic Park.
Oh yeah.
That was awesome. And of course, I love that dream. And I kind of like how the direction that they went with it. It's not as Pink Diamond herself, but we're seeing it as Stevonnie because it is their dream. And I do love the design of Pink Diamond, even though we get it for like just 2 sweet, sweet seconds. It's something to look forward to. And I like seeing Pink Diamond, we kind of get the sense of a hierarchy. So that code, like the white, yellow, blue, then pink, it's really a symbol of like white diamonds first, yellow second, blue's third, and then fourth is last. And she shows that with her attitude.
So is Pink Diamond like a little stubborn little brat, or?
Kind of, at this point, yeah. She wants to get what she wants, and she wants to prove to everybody that she can do it because she's a diamond.
Do you think she was ready for this?
I don't think so, no.
I don't think so either, because if she's the first one to be shattered out of them, something had to have happened. And something in her character had to have happened to get her destroyed. So
Gundam, what did you like about this episode then?
I loved, again, colors were amazing on the planet. You got to see the vibrant colors in the night, the day, the rain effects looked great. I loved plot, again, going forward, absolutely amazing. The character development, being able to see Stevonnie really survive in the wilderness, and you know, she has stubble, which was awesome as well. I really loved the tone of the episode too, because it really didn't have music in this, but it set the tone by not setting a tone for the episode.
I feel like if they had music, it would have
cheapened the experience.
Yeah, it just would have been real. It just needed to be real subtle because there was so much plot that they didn't want to distract with the music.
And going off what Red said about the dream sequence, I really like how they did it because it's not just Steven dreaming this time, it's Stevonnie dreaming this time. So both his and her mind are thinking this up. So that's why you see Connie's mom, but you also see the gym. And then that's why it kind of goes back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And I thought that was fantastic.
So one question, guys. What part of that dream actually was Stevonnie or a memory? Because it seemed like it switched from being just a dream to a memory.
I feel like it was a memory.
Yeah, I think it was because Connie has such a relationship with her mom about, you know, being ignored. You know, she's always working. You know, she's never home. That's why she has all these different, like, recitals that she does for all different things. And she really, you know, doesn't let her really do anything. Just like Yellow Diamond is the pink, so that's why it was taking on Connie's. Like, Connie was able to kind of use that to build that full memory to fill in the pieces, fill in the gaps, because you know how his dream sequence that Steven has usually are really fragmented, if it makes any sense.
Oh, yeah. So, what I liked about this episode was pretty much everything, that plot, and even more plot in the lore. I love the lore of this. We needed this for a while. On a little side note, it's kind of interesting that every January of every year, the last 3 years, we had a new reveal of a diamond. 2016, we had a reveal of Yellow Diamond. 2017, we had a reveal of Blue Diamond. And now we have Pink Diamond. So are we going to have to wait another year for White Diamond?
I hope not. I really don't. I don't want to wait that long. But again, how long have we been waiting for this?
Oh, yeah.
Too long.
Yeah, way too long.
Way too long.
I'm gonna go into the dislikes, guys. Anybody have any dislikes?
Nope.
I dislike that there isn't more. Please give me
more.
Oh,
okay. I also don't like that there isn't more. Please be more. This is a perfect time to do a straight-to-video movie or straight-to-Blu-ray movie or straight-to-Cartoon Network movie where they just go through the journey of Lars getting back to Earth and then they can wrap all that whole thing up. Maybe do a couple fights and then back to Earth, everything's good, the end.
Well, that's a long stretch for Cartoon Network. I don't think we're ever going to get that. But I really have no dislikes. Like, again, I would have to be nitpicking just to get a dislike on this list. And there's no justice in that. So no dislikes from me either. So we're going to go into the ratings.
Oh, sorry. One thing. It's not really a dislike, it's that nitpicking. It's just the spelling and the grammar.
Yeah.
That was it. The spelling of the, like when they were in the pod and said, what did it say?
It said engineer or engine, but it didn't have, like, it had an R, but it didn't have two E's at the end for engineer, so it was, like, misspelled. And then, like, Emerald's name was spelled wrong. Fluorite was spelled fluorite. It just had a couple errors.
But that's it, pretty much.
Literally nitpicking there. It's nothing that, it didn't draw away from the episode.
I didn't even notice it the first run.
It was nothing that affected my overall enjoyment of the episode. Mm-hmm. They did a really good job.
Let's go to the ratings. Red, what do you give it?
5 out of 5.
Gundam?
5 out of 5. If I could go higher, I would. 5 out of 5.
Unfortunately, I made the rule that we can't go any higher than 5 or 5. So guess what? 5 out of 5 for me. So, thank you guys so much for listening to us and enjoying this double episode of Steven Universe. Don't know when we're going to get another one. We're on hiatus status once again.
Again.
I hope that they just at least give us a progress. Did you see that Cartoon Network 2018 trailer? They're like, we got new shows, we're bringing back old shows. 2018 is going to be our biggest year ever.
3 seconds of Steven Universe? Yeah.
That's what I'm saying, is that they say it's the biggest, but are they really going to do it? Because I think they said something like that starting last year too, and this year was abysmal for their cartoons. So, we'll see.
I know Cartoon Network's getting a lot of new shows, and I'm hoping that takes away from Teen Titans Go and leaves the rest alone.
Yeah.
So, well, thank you guys again. And thank you, Red, for coming with us again on this.
Yeah, it's always a pleasure. This was a great episode to watch with you guys. So, a lot of fun.
And don't forget, guys, to like, subscribe. Make sure to click that notification bell. Leave a comment down below. We really love hearing from you guys. And we'll have some links in the description, and Red has some links in the description as well, too.
So yeah, I have an Instagram, I'm at Perfectly Red, and then I have a Facebook page at Perfectly Red Cosplay.
Thank you guys once again. Good night.
See you.
Bye, everybody.